So, permission to be here for the hour. Any budget trouble? Your worry? Burden you carry on your shoulder, your back, even all on the side. Give yourself this time just to be still. Focus on your deep breath. Each inhale, expand your stomach and chest. Exhale, push your stomach in. Your deep breathing. Allow your shoulder to relax. Relax your facial muscle. Chin into your chest, interlace your hand, place behind your head, sit up nice and tall, shoulder relaxed, and breathe. You're gonna stay here. Don't pull on your head, shoulder relax. Exhale to your right. Inhale, open. Exhale to your left. Inhale, open. Exhale to your right. Inhale, open. Exhale to your left. Three more. Inhale, open. Exhale to your right. Two more. Inhale, open. Exhale to your left. Inhale, open. Exhale to your right. Back to your center. Open that elbow. Let your head fall back. Lift your chest up. We're going to stay here for about a minute. I'm just going to time it. Deep breath. Shoulder down. Stop. connection between all the way to your buttock and to your lower back. And you may feel in your groin and your hip. So if you do, that means that area is very tight. So breathe. Two more. One more. And release. Still hold your breath. Just feel your hip area, your buttock, your hamstring, and your lower back. The bottom knee is nice and stable in your hand, and then just gently push your knee down, but don't force, so make sure you're stable, and then hold your hand in position and use your muscles, so elbow bent in, and use your wrist and the palm of your hand to push it down. Now lift the chest up and breathe. Shoulder going downward instead of upwards, so the muscle is elongate and open up. So nice and gentle movement. Keep your body still. The only thing that moves is your head, not your body. Only your head. Breathe. That's it. Nice and gentle. Deep breath. right shoulder. Sit up as tall as you can and just tuck your chin slightly in and then let your shoulder relax. Keep that back nice and tall by lifting your chest up and releasing your neck and shoulder muscles. Breathe. Deep breath. Let your head go. Breathe into that tight neck. Deep breathing into your chest. Deeper. Into your chest. A little bit more. Three more breaths. In your shoulder joint and your shoulder and neck muscle. Feel that release of the tension that you've been carrying around. Teach your body how to feel relaxed. Tell your body this is what you want to feel and learn to remember the relaxed feeling you have. Consciously drop your shoulder down. A little bit taller if possible. Three more breaths in from your chest. Now bring your ankle to your knee one more. We're going to really open up the hip today. It's your favorite thing to do. Alright, bring your opposite elbow to your knee. So if you can, keep that palm face away. Now, turn that chest to the opposite, to that same direction. Roll the shoulder back, the other arm behind the back, if possible, and try to straighten out your lower back. Straighten out your lower back. And breathe, shoulder down. Lift the chest open. Now, as you come there, breathe. Feel that? Deep breath, shoulder down. Look over your shoulder, continue as, don't force. The movement comes from here, your lower back. Three deep breaths, inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Beautiful. Last deep breath. And back to your center. Feel a big breath to feel that loosen up in your spine, in your hip. deep breath. Beautiful. Back to your center. Still deep breath. Press your left arm over your head, like a dead weight. Relax your head, drop your right arm down. Breathe deeply. Your shoulder go, you can, don't force the movement. Just allow it to drop down naturally. Try to keep that back nice and tall. Two deep breath into your chest. Last deep breath. And back to your center. Be still. Feel the weight of the heaviness of your shoulder release. breathe. That is. A little deeper from here. Drop your head down. Two deep breath. Last deep breath. Now take your time, don't rush. Roll your body up. One vertebra at a time. Use your hand, place it on your knee. Help you come up nice and slow if you need to. Be still. Roll the shoulder back, open up your chest. Deep breathe. Three more breath. Two more. One more. Now interlace your hand behind your back. Roll your shoulder back. Now if you want, open up your legs a little bit wider so you have room in front of you. We're going to fold forward. One more. Bring your wrist over your head and down to the floor. Drop your head down. Allow the spine to realign your neck and shoulder. This could be quite an intense. Shoulder relax. Let your head go. You can just breathe into this session here. Deep breath. Breathe as deeply as you can. Continue to bring that wrist over your head and down to the floor. That's it. And then hold it in position when you go, can go any farther. And then try to relax both shoulders if possible. Deep breath, drop your head down, drop your head down. Bring your wrist over your head. Two deep breath. One more. Now, drop your head down. Place your hand on your knee if you need to help you come up. Otherwise, roll your body up. One vertebra at a time. Breathe, you'll feel the nice differences. Deep breath. Turn your chin to your right shoulder. Bring your chin down into your chest. Place your right hand over your head and then relax. Deep breath. Deep breathing. Now, breathe into your neck and shoulder. This is a very, very neck. Intent next opening, but don't force anything, just allow gravity to do the rest of the work. Breathe, just relax, pass it, relax your shoulder, feel that breathe, into your chest, back straight, two more breath, last deep breath. Back to your center. Be still, be still. Just feel the differences between the two sides. Breathe. Don't move. Just let your body adapt to that release of your tension. Relax and open up. insulate your hand and the breath on your head. Have a dead weight and we're gonna hang there. Again, drop your head down. We're gonna try to stay here for 1 minute. So it could be quite intense, but it will help realign your spine, releasing your neck and shoulder tension, and realign your neck and your back vertebra. So deep breath. Again, don't force, just gently relax. Breathe into that low back. Drop your head down. Drop your head down and relax. Relax your shoulder. Relax your back. Deep breathe and feel that nice opening. That's it. You feel that? Breathe, breathe deeply. Continue with that deep breath. Don't force. Don't force anything. Relax. Breathe to your back. Let your head down naturally. That's it. Yes, it's quite intense for your hamstring. You can bend your hips slightly to release the tension on your back leg. If you can keep your leg straight, that's better. But the main purpose is working on your back, not your leg for this one. Breathe. Two deep breaths. One more. Now, gently sit down. Come to sitting position and come back up and relax. Take your time to feel that nice tension release. Movement. Place your right elbow to your left knee. And then bring your hand together and then turn and straighten on the lower back. That's it. Deep breath. That's it now. Don't force. Open up your chest. Open. Lift your chest up. 3 deep breath here. Two more. One more. Beautiful. Back to center. We come to meditation from here. Breathe. Find comfortable position. Try to sit a little bit taller now that your body nice and open. Don't use the chair for support. Use your core muscle, roll your shoulder back. Teach your body to be strong. And either have your eye closed or open. Focus at the point. Consciously drop your shoulder down. And mindful of your head and your body. So the neck alignment to your spine. So tuck your chin slightly in, bringing the body a little bit taller. Now keep that position, and each time you inhale, try to expand that chest a little bit taller and bigger, and shoulder open up a little bit more. And every time you exhale in, push your stomach in, keep your body tall. Open up your chest, lift your body up, exhale, push your stomach in. Thank you. D breathing should be technically natural for us, but it's not. Because none of us do them on a daily basis, so it's not a second nature. So if you practice deep breathing on a regular basis, so eventually it becomes second nature. So it basically you develop a new habit. So if you don't do that, then it's not easy for you to do. But it also, practicing deep breathing, it also helps you focus the mind. So because your mind tends to be very distracted, you think about, you know, your grocery list, the thing that you need to do this, or this and this. So when you practice that deep breathing, just because it forces you to actually be conscious of when the breath comes in or the breath comes out, and which part of your body is working. So to do that is a form of meditation itself. So it disciplines the mind. That's pretty much like that. That is part of meditation. And eventually, when you get over that stage, it becomes an inherent, it becomes what you call a natural flow. Then you have to train the mind to be still because you did nothing out distracted now because you don't have to use your mind to follow that thread. So now you have to say, oh, now I have to actually focus on quiet down the mind. So it's the second state of meditation. They're like different states. So the first state is physical, second state is mental, third state is trying to relax. Again, it comes back to the physical muscle. So you have to constantly let everything go while you pass through the first two states. And then the next day after that is about the nothingness, about being still, about being in the present. And then the final state of meditation is the state of oneness, meaning you aware of everything, but you completely relax. So that state, really, you're doing that every night before you go to bed. So the 2 seconds or like the 5 seconds that before you fall asleep, you kind of like, huh, you know, and then you forgot about everything. That actually meditation state. So you want to get into that state of meditation. That is a meditation. So that 5 different states that we practice. So that's all it is. It's not thing really complicated. It's just what you need to practice. But you only know how to meditate because before you fall asleep. That's a state of meditation, but the state of surrendering, the state of relaxation, and you notice your breath is also slowed down just before you fall asleep. You know, your mind becomes quiet. You meditate every night before you go to bed. So all I'm doing is kind of like teach you the step to get there.